Hello students, welcome to EBG Pathshala. I am Dr. Neil Kumar from Center for Medical Biotechnology. Today we are going to discuss about our module Transgenic Animal and Method of Their Creation under the paper Animal Cell Biotechnology. So what will be our learning objective in this module? In this module we are going to discuss about transgenic animals and the method of their creation. After this lecture, student will be able to learn the basic concept of transgenic animal. They will learn about different methodology which are available. They will learn about the ethical, social and the legal concern associated with this technology. They will know about the application in different areas like medical application, industrial application and agriculture application. So introduction to transgenic animal and their method of creations. With the advent of technology like recombinant DNA technology, we are able to produce transgenic animal. Transgenic animal are those animal which is carrying foreign gene that has been deleted, inserted into their genome. The whole process known as the transgenesis. Transgenesis is a process by which we are mixing up genes from one species and the second species. It is the process of introduction of foreign DNA into the genome. That foreign DNA known as the transgene, which is basically a stable in heritable manner. Transgenesis technology, it is being produced for the production of livestock. It is being production of transgenic pig. It is being used for the production of transgenic fishes. It is used for the production of transgenic mice, which has application is in different area like medical, agriculture and the industrial application. So what historical development has taken place in transgenic animal? Starting from 1985, first transgenic livestock was produced. In 1991, high level of production of pharmaceutical drug achieved. In 1992, the first attempt was made to engineer disease resistance in transgenic livestock. In 1994, generation of pigs that can express the human complement in vitro was done. In 1996, transgenics attempt to improve wool production in sheep, and it led to the development of nuclear transfer technique. In 1997, that was the landmark in the history of transgenic animal. The creation of Dolly was happened. The first livestock transgenic produced by nuclear transfer technology. In 2000, first gene targeting in livestock was produced. In 2001, transgenic livestock produced to address the environmental issue. In this case, first heterozygote gene knockout was done. 2003, first homozygote gene knockout was done in livestock. So why transgenic animals? Transgenic animals are being created for the purpose of research and commercial interest. So we are having three type of research: academic research, application research and the biomedical research. Under the academic research, we are using transgenic animal for the genetic regulation of development and growth. Under the application research, we are using transgenic animal for the production of valuable drugs for animal and the human welfare. For the biomedical research, we are generating animal model and cell line for studying the pathogenesis and the prevention of disease in human. Now in commercial interest, we are producing two kind of product: conventional product and the non-conventional product. The conventional product are produced for the higher quantity, for example meat, milk, leather is wool, etc. And for the synthesis of non-conventional product, we are using animal as a bioreactor for the production of interferon, for the production of antitrypsin. How we can produce transgenic animal? There are the two important steps are there. First, we have to construct a transgene, then we have to introduce that foreign gene or transgene into the animal. So how we can construct what is the basically component of transgene? Transgene contain a promoter gene to be expressed and the termination gene. As you know, promoter is the basically part of a DNA sequence which is needed for the initiation of transcription. So for the introduction of a transgene into the animal, we have employed the different type of methodology, like we are having micro injection, retroviral mediated gene transfer, embryo stem cell mediated transfer, nuclear cell transfer. We can also employ the other technique also for the transfer of these transgene into the animal models. So first method we have discussed in last slide, there is a micro injection. It was the first reported in 1985. Most of the transgenic animal are created in this way. Now what is the procedure for micro injection? First, remove the egg from superovulated female, then fertilize it in vitro, and inject transgene is your gene of interest directly into the male pronucleus. That male pronucleus is the nucleus which is prior to the nuclear fusion. Then egg with the transgene are kept overnight in the CO2 incubator to develop the two cell stage. Then they are implanted into the surrogate mother, and that will lead to the progeny of transgenic animals. In this figure, there is a super ovulated female from which egg has been taken. There is a female pronucleus and the male pronucleus, and the male under in male pronucleus we are inserting our transgene, that is gene of our interest. After the inserting transgene in the male nucleus, we are implanting that gene into the surrogate mother. Then it is producing the transgenic mice. Now, what are the advantages and disadvantages of this technique, microinjection? Now, microinjection has advantages like stable integration. It is a rapid technique, transfer of large number of gene possible, and no selection of transgene necessary. And what are the disadvantages? Low efficiency. It is lies between 1% to 30%. Random insertion of the gene, high frequency of mosaic, and the variable expression level. Okay, this is the disadvantage. Second method of gene transfer into animals, we are having retroviral mediated gene transfer. What is a retrovirus? Retrovirus is a virus which is carrying a genetic material as a RNA. So it can be used as a vector. It has been used in a gene transfer method due to its infection properties. So what is the procedure for retroviral mediated gene transfer? So in this case, we are going to have virus, retrovirus. Retrovirus gene will be replaced by the gene of interest, our that is known as transgene. Retrovirus are then used to act as a vector that will transfer your transgene into the host cell, resulting in the chimera. Chimera is basically hybrid of your gene and the gene of interest, that is a transgene. Now, chimera is an organism which is consisting of a tissue or parts of diverse genetic constitution. In retroviral method, we will use the retrovirus. Retrovirus are those viruses which is having a RNA as its genome. These are used as the vector. So in this case, in particular figure, we are having donor female from which we are extracting a egg that will be grown into the 8 cell embryo. Now, after which in retrovirus we are replacing this virus gene with our gene of interest. Then this virus going to infect the cell and it will transfer the genome interest into the that particular cell, and that cell will be re-implanted into the female mice, and that will produce the progeny that will be of transgenic nature. There are the disadvantages and advantages of this method also, that is the retroviral mediated gene transfer. What are the advantages? It infects early stage embryo with the replication defective virus. The method allows only small DNA insert up to less than 8 kb only possible there. What are the disadvantages? Random insertion of transgene occur, retroviral contamination sometimes happen. So in this slide, we are going to discuss about embryonic stem cell mediated transfer. Now, what is the procedure for this gene transfer? First, you have to isolate the blastocyst from mouse. Now, how you can obtain blastocyst? Blastocyst basically a 16 cell stage. In blastocyst, we are interested in the inner cell mass. Inner cell mass of blastocyst, after that their isolation, why we are interested in inner cell mass? Because inner cell mass has a pluripotent property, and we are culturing this inner cell mass. After their culturing, we will employ the gene targeting for insertion of our gene of interest or transgene into the embryonic stem cell. After the injection of genetically modified embryonic stem cell into the cavity of blastocyst from the different mouse strain, we do the re-implantation into the foster mother, and after this it will lead to the production of progeny that will be producing the transgenic animal. Now, what are the advantages of this method? This method is time and cost intensive, and it has a site specific integration because of the gene target. We are going to discuss about the embryonic stem cell mediated gene transfer. So for this transfer, we need a donor blastocyst, and from the donor blastocyst, which is a 16 cell stage, from this blastocyst we are going to isolate inner cell mass. Inner cell mass is basically our cell of interest in which we are going to transfer our transgene. Transgene is basically a foreign gene we are going to interest. So after the injection of transgene, the cell will be enriched for the infected embryonic stem cells. Now, after the enrichment, the blastocyst, which is containing transgene, will be implanted in the mice, and that will lead to the progeny, mixed progeny, and some of them will be having the transgenic nature. Our next method is the cloning by the nuclear transfer, also known as the somatic cell nuclear transfer. The Dolly was the first female which was created by using this technique, that known as the SCNT, somatic cell nuclear transfer. Now, what is the procedure for this technique? In SCNT, we are extracting a nucleus from the somatic cell, and then we are inserting that nucleus into the egg, enucleated egg. Now, after being inserted into the egg, the somatic cell nucleus is reprogrammed by the host cell. The egg now is containing nucleus of the somatic cell, will be given the shock to divide. Now, after the many mitotic division from a single cell, it will lead to the formation of blastocyst that will be implanted in the foster mother, that will lead to the progeny of transgenic animal. Now, cloning by nuclear transfer. You can see the things. We are having an ovum, a somatic cell, and the egg cell. Basically, we are taking a nucleus from a somatic cell, and then we are inserting that nucleus into the enucleated egg cell. After the insertion of those cells, it will lead to the fusion of those. That fused cell will be grown in vitro. After it reaching the particular cell stage, after 16 cell stage, it will be implanted in the foster mother or surrogate mother, and that will lead to the production of cloned sheep. And Dolly was produced by using this technique, that known as the somatic cell nuclear transfer. What are the advantage and disadvantage? Advantage: it has the potential to used to produce extinct species. It can retain genetic code of the donor nucleus. It is a common procedure and the method which is easily available. What are the disadvantage? Often result in the abnormal phenotype in clones due to the incomplete reprogramming. It is an efficient process which is having study reporting basically the 0.5 to 5% efficiency. Sperm mediated gene transfer. In 1989, Levitron et al. Described the efficient technique based on the internal ability of sperm cell. This ability allowed the sperm cell to bind and internalize exogenous DNA molecule and transfer them into the oocyte at the fertilization stage. Now, fertilization could be an in vitro or artificial insemination, or it can be a waterborne fertilization for basically aquatic animal. Sperm mediated gene transfer, also known as the SMGAT procedure, it was the first introduced in the small animals like mice. Later on, the studies on large animals such as a pig was reported. Now, what are the advantages of this technique? It has a high efficiency, low cost, ease of use, and do not require any embryo handling or expensive equipment. You can see the sperm mediated gene transfer in pigs has been shown there. You have collection of ejaculate from the donor sperm, then you are removing the seminal fluid from the sperm. Then after you have removed the seminal fluid, you are infusing that particular sperm with our gene of interest. Then sperm DNA interaction happen, and then you are again implanting into the recipient. That will lead to the production of the transgenic pig. There are various transgenic animal has been produced till now. So some of the examples are given as like mice, pig, rabbit, cow, goat, sheep, chicken, monkey, cat, guinea pig is there, horse, fish, spider, dog, rats. There is a huge list of animal transgenics which has been produced by these techniques. Transgenic mice. So first we are going to discuss about the transgenic mice. The first transgenic animal were mice created by Rudolph in 1974. He inserted foreign DNA into the early stage mouse embryo, resulting in the mice carrying modified gene. So what are the knockout mice? We are having different type of transgenic mice. First is the knockout mice. It is widely used in medical research to investigate gene function as they have their selected gene inactivated. So knockout mice are those mice which are carrying the non-functional gene at the place of gene of interest. So these can be used for genetic analysis of inherited disease and the cancer. And transgenic mice were generated based on the inheritance pattern of human disease. Therefore, they can be used for the introduction of collagen gene in mice, which can produce knockout mice suffering from the osteogenesis which can be used for the treatment of the disease osteogenesis. So when we are introducing the HIV TET gene in a mice, is basically knockout mice, that can be used for the treatment of Kaposi's sarcoma. Under the transgenic mice, alternative mice which has been produced, known as the super mouse, onco mouse, smart mouse. Now, what are the features of this mouse? Super mouse was developed by the Ralph Brisner in 1982. It has the ability of superior learning and the memory. It was used for the meat production. It was produced by introducing rat growth hormone gene into the mouse, which resulted in the high level of growth hormone, and it has attained approximately double the weight of normal offspring mouse. Onco mouse, it was the first patented transgenic animal. It was developed to study the cancer and to screen the anti-tumor drug. It was made by inserting activated oncogenes, and 30 different strains were engineered to contain human oncogene causing tumor formation. Next is a smart mouse. It was engineered to overexpress the NR at the rate of B receptor in the synaptic pathway. It increases the efficiency of mice to learn faster like juvenile throughout their life. Now, what are the disadvantages of transgenic mice? This technique basically is expensive. Gene can be only added or deleted. Embryos are not easily accessible for manipulation. Transgenic livestock. So, microinjection is a most common method of gene transfer which can be used for the creation of transgenic livestock. It has low efficiency as compared to the transgenic mice. We have produced many various type of transgenic livestock. Our first one is the transgenic cow. Rosie was the first transgenic cow which was produced in 1997. Now, transgenic cow containing two types of casein gene produces 13% more milk comparison to the normal cow. Transgenic cow with the K casein gene insert produce milk rich in the K casein, which is further used for the cheese making. We have also produced cattle with the lactose gene insert, which produce milk which are rich in lactose. We have also produced livestock which are prion free. As we know, prion can cause the mad cow disease in cattle. Transgenic sheep, we have also produced under the transgenic livestock. Tracy was the first transgenic animal to produce recombinant protein in its milk. It was used for good quality of wool production. It can be used as a model organism to study the immunology, human blood clotting factor, 11 transplantation, hematology, biological product manufacturing, recombinant DNA, and drug production in milk. Under the transgenic livestock, we have also produced transgenic goats. It is mainly developed for the animal farming. Transgenic goat could express the tissue plasminogen activator, antithrombin, spider silk, etc. in the milk. Now, TPA gene of plasminogen tissue also helps in dissolving blood clots. Silk gene are transferred from spider in order to produce the several gram of silk protein in her milk. The monoclonal antibodies, Ig fusion proteins, TPA, recombinant human antithrombin, is the first transgenic recombinant protein which was produced from the transgenic goat. Now, what are the disadvantages of transgenic livestock? They are expensive as usual, difficult procedure, we have to adopt, and failed in vitro production. We are going to discuss about transgenic pig. The pigs are the only animal whose physiology matches to the that of humans. Most common example of transgenic pig is the Enviro pig. The normal pig faces trouble in fully digesting a compound known as a phytase, found in many cereal grains of their diet, while the transgenic pig are created by introduction of phytase gene obtained from E. coli bacteria. The phytase enzyme in a salivary gland of transgenic pig, which helps in the degradation of indigestible phytase by releasing a phosphate enzyme, pigs can easily digest phosphatase. A genetically engineered pig approved for limited production, which produces 65% of less phosphorus in animal waste. Now, transgenic pig can also be used for the organ transplant harvesting. Transgenic pigs inserted with the human beta globulin gene produce human hemoglobin in blood, and it is used to treat hemophilia disease. Now, what are the disadvantages of transgenic pig? A breeding problem, that is the first of the disadvantages. Mutation occurs and the release of phosphate that are harmful for environment. In this slide, we are going to discuss about the transgenic fish. Transgenic fish are produced by artificial transfer of gene into the fertilized egg. The microinjection, as usual, is the common method which is being used for the transgenic fish. There are the different type of transgenic fish has been produced: super fish, glowfish. Super fish like salmon, trout, and the catfish are example. Growth hormone gene are inserted into fertilized eggs by microinjection method. They have extra copy of growth hormone, and that lead to the increased growth and the size up to 6 times faster than the control fish. Glowfish example is a zebra fish. Ornamental glowfish are being produced by integrating a fluorescent protein gene from jellyfish into the embryo of a fish. It is the first genetically modified animal to become publicly available as a pet. It contains red, green, yellow, and orange fluorescent color. We are going to discuss about the application of transgenic animal. Transgenic technology hold a great potential in different group of areas which benefit the animal to human welfare. It has an application in medical field, agriculture field, and industrial field. First, coming to the medical application, they are being used as a disease model for human, for studying genetic basis of human and animal disease such as cancer, cystic fibrosis, Alzheimer disease. They are being used for disease resistance in human and animals. They are used for the production of drug and product, and they are also used for the testing of drugs. Second application is they can be used for the production of pharmaceuticals in transgenic animals. Now, transgenic cow, sheep, and goats are able to provide nutritional supplements such as insulin, growth hormone, and blood clotting factors. The next application is in transplantation. The patient die every year due to the lack of organ for replacement. So these animal are alternatives, especially the transgenic pig, are being used for transplanted organ. The second application is in agriculture field. In agriculture field, they are used for breeding and the quality purpose. The transgenics had made it possible to develop desired traits such as increased milk production, high growth rate by selective breeding in animal in a shorter time with more precision. It also increases the yield production in cattle. For the quality purpose, a transgenic bull, Harman, was developed that carries a human gene for lactoferrin, which increases the iron content. So transgenic pig, another example, transgenic pig and cattle be approximately double than the normal animals which are being used for the meat production. Transgenic sheep, it can be used for the more wool production. So scientists are attempting to develop disease resistant animal such as influenza resistant pigs, but this phase is limited to certain genes. The last application is in an industrial field. The extraction of the polymer strand from the milk helped the scientists to create light, tough, flexible material that are used to further for weaving military uniforms, medical microstructure, tennis rackets, and string. The second application is to produce wide variety of enzymes, microorganisms, which are engineered through the transgenics, which are also capable of producing enzyme that can speed up the industrial chemical reactions. Now we are going to discuss about the ethical concerns which are associated with the creation of transgenic animals. The genetically modified animals have been intentionally designed to suit the human purposes. We know we are producing a transgenic animal for our need. So there are the certain controversial issues also related with the transgenic animal production. Some of the progress are considered morally unacceptable, like cloning, when we are doing the cloning. There are some moral or ethical factor to the genetic manipulation. So it follows the principle of 3R. The first principle is the reduction of animal number, refinement of practices, and the husbandry to minimize the pain and distress. The third principle is the replacement of animal with non-animal alternative wherever possible. So there is a concern about animal welfare, because when we are using animals, use of animal in research causes great suffering to the animals. Each biological species has a right to exist as a separate identifiable identity. So animals should have the same basic right as we are giving to the humans. Due to the experimentation, it had diminished the sense of identity and the individuality to animals. Other issues we can consider, that is the genotransplantation issue. As we are using the transgenic pig for the transplantation, so genotransplantation issue arises when we are transferring the organ from human to the pig or from pig to the humans. So transplantation organ from transgenic pig to human can spread zoonotic disease such as the mad cow disease that could have devastating consequences and implications. So let's summarize our lecture. So coming to the introduction part of our lecture, we have discussed about what are the transgenic animal. Transgenic animal are those animal which is containing a foreign gene or transgene, the process known as the transgenesis. Then we have discussed why there is a need of transgenic animal. Because we are producing transgenic animal for the purpose of research and commercial interest. For the purpose of research, we are doing the academic research, application research, and the biomedical research. And the, for the commercial interest, we are producing them for the conventional products like meat, milk, and for we are producing them for the non-conventional products like interferon, antitrypsin. Then we have discussed about what are the basically method for producing the transgene. For the production of transgenic animal, we need a transgene, and the second part, we need a method of gene transfer. Transgene, important component of transgene is a promoter and the part of gene which are going to be expressed. And the, for the gene transfer method, we are having different method. The first method we have discussed about, that was the micro injection. Then we have discussed about the retroviral mediated gene transfer. Then we discussed about sperm mediated transfer, somatic cell nuclear transfer we have discussed. So all these methods have certain pros and cons. We have discussed also those. So what are the application why we are producing this transgenic animal? They have certain application. They have application in medical field, agriculture field, industrial field. We have produced different kind of transgenic animal, like we have produced transgenic mice. Under the transgenic mice, we have produced super mouse, knockout mice, onco mouse. We have produced transgenic livestock, transgenic sheep, transgenic cow we have produced. And they have certain application. They are being used for the treatment of disease. They are used for the production of conventional product like meat, wool. And then we are having application in the industrial field. In industrial field, they are being used for the production of certain vaccines. They are being produced. They are being used as an animal model. They are used for the production of military uniform. They are used for the production of the tennis racket. Now to the application, we have discussed the what are the ethical concerns we have to deal when we are producing the transgenic animal. When we are producing a transgenic animal, the main concern comes the because of us, the animal are suffering. That is a main concern. And we have also discussed about the concern that related to the transplantation. So when we are doing the transplantation, sometime our body reject. The second concern is related with the genotransplantation. In transplantation, we are transferring organ from one organism to the another. For this purpose, we are using the transgenic pig. When we are transferring organ from the transgenic pig to ourselves, that can cause the immunological problem, like that can cause the graft rejection also.